Good afternoon, everyone. I'm so sorry I've been running a bit late. I was at my store in Mehroli, and I'm just with some appointments, and then I told the bride I have to rush. And I almost, like in the last 10 minutes, changed, did my hair, whatever, covered this scarf to cover my stomach, and I'm here. And yeah, it's actually not 30 years, it's 28 years.
28
I'm getting a little touchy about age and work. You know, after you cross 50, you get touchy, so it's 28 years.
Chalo, have a seat. Round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Manish Malhotra. Okay, let's begin my first memory, and I'd like to call on stage Myra. She's a saxophone player. So for your introduction, we prepared something special. Can we have Myra on stage? How it all started, you know, my first memory of Manish Malhotra. I remember in films there was Costume Dada, and just, you know, these designers who were not really designers, but they used to do costume for films. And then Manish broke onto the scene. I think you were the first one, the original fashion designer. So if we have Myra on stage, and we have a little slideshow of how it all began, you know, the magic of Manish Malhotra. Round of applause for Myra, our lovely saxophone player. So we're going to play a slideshow of the original Manish Malhotra collection. You remember this? Round of applause, and I want to thank you personally for this. I think it was a great memory watching Rangila. I think the first time and thank you, Myra. Thank you so much. You were lovely. That I remember that, you know, the costumes spoke to me as a viewer. It was wild and it was sexy, and what a great time. I mean, Rangila was iconic. Talk to me about these days.
Well, I think that there have been actors who've been really iconic with style. So you had Devanand, who shopped in the 60s also in London, and you had Meena Kumari, who you know, looked into her own costumes, and all of costumes of Pakiza were done by her, including the jewelry. So I think all those actors who were very, very precise in their dressing, you know, they used to go to Taj, to Burlington, Shami Kapoor would go to get his blazers made, or I remember Asha Parikh ji telling me that she would go to a French lady to get her trousers made, and that French lady had a store in Kulaba. And of course, there was Bhanu Attaya, who was brilliant in all the work that she had done. And then for a brief time, we had Xerxes, who did a lot of sequence work with Parveen Babi in all those films. So I think my entire childhood was in a film theater. I grew up in a film theater. I was just fascinated with films. And I remember at the age of 6, I told my teacher that your shoes are not matching. And my mother was like, why are you bothered about her shoes? You concentrate on your studies. So I was just very fascinated with films. And I think my mother didn't really object to it. So every Thursday when I had a holiday, I would be watching a film. So I think I grew up so wide-eyed about films. I used to wonder, will I ever be invited to a film party? Will I ever meet a film star? Will all that ever happen? So my cousin sister got married to David Dhawan, and that's how I got my first break, because I started working in a boutique. I was very interested in clothes. There was no design course in Mumbai at that time, and I didn't have the money to go abroad to study fashion. So, and the fashion movement in India was just starting. Ensemble with lots of designers had just got launched. And I was like, I can never be there because I don't know too much about clothes and technicality, and neither am I educated, because all I know is films. So why don't I look at films? And why don't I start? I love clothes. I'm working in a boutique. And I think the films need a look. If I can change that look, I'll be able to make a name. So with that thought, I got into films. And David G really connected me to Juhi Chawla, where I designed for a song. And Rakesh Shrestha was the photographer at that time. He took me to Sri Devi. And I remember meeting Sridevi for the first time, and I was really fascinated. I was at a film shoot meeting all of them, not because I could sketch. I sketch very fast and paint. I sketch so fast that all the actors got quite impressed with my sketches. They said, while he's talking, he's sketching. And so here I was 23 years of age, 1990, and I was running to Sunny Deol, Chunky Pandey, Sridevi, and it was crazy. Till I met Ram Gopal Verma, I did a film called Govinda Govinda for him, for Sridevi. And that's how he called me for Rangila. And that's how the entire makeover happened. And then all like-minded people like Aditya Chopra, Karan Johar, all of us met, who are very into movies. And that entire phase of 90s, which became the changing phase of costumes and movies.
Right, but specifically about this film, you know, because it all came together. RGV's brilliance and his magic, A.R. Rahman's music, then Urmila, Amir, Jackie, and all of those people. But just about these looks, how did you select? Because they were sort of a rage at those times, you know, these costumes. Nobody had seen a Hindi film heroine sporting those dazzling reds or these, you know, pristine whites.
So I think before Rangila, whenever I entered a film producer's office, he would look at me and say, you're the costume designer. Are you the heroine's brother? Are you the heroine's friend? I mean, they looked at you with a lot of resentment. And whenever I asked for a script or I asked for what is she playing, they would be like, why do you want to know that? We just want you to make her look sexy. In fact, the first brief I had got was that she's going for a funeral and she has to look sexy. And I kept thinking, how do I make her look sexy at a funeral? And slowly I understood he meant the fit. The fit has to be really tight, you know? And that's how I kind of caught on, because I was so interested that I would catch what was not being told or things that were being told. And Ram Gopal Verma was the first director who actually narrated a film script to me. I remember it was in Hyderabad, and I was so impressed. I felt so important that somebody's actually narrating a script to me. And his whole thing was that we got to do something really good. I loved your work in Govinda Govinda with Sridevi, and that was a Tamil film, Telugu film. And so that's how it started. So it was basically, I think, it was like a lot of like-minded people who wanted to do new things. And my contribution was styling, which is what I introduced in India. What's the hair? What's the makeup? What shoes is she going to wear? But in this scene before, she had long hair. So before I came into films, what used to happen is if it's a traditional scene, the heroine has a long choti, flowers, long hair. Next scene, she's wearing a Western outfit, her hair is short. So I had mentioned this to Sridevi in a film called Gumra, which I was doing, and I said, your hair shouldn't change. How could your length change? You can do different styles. So these were all the styling things that I started. In fact, a lot of the makeup artists at that time were very uncomfortable with me interfering in makeup and hair and what are her shoes, what's her nail polish, all of that. And I was so interested in films that I would ask questions on a script. You know, that why is she doing this? She just did this now. In fact, you'd be surprised, a lot of actresses didn't ask at that time. There's this one narration we were having with a director and an actress. And an actress was making notes. You know, she was going on making notes. So then he said, it's in trouble after 1 hour narration. So she said, I'm going to the loo. So he told me, my God, she's so interested. I love the way she was making notes. She came out and she told him, I made notes, there are only 5 changes. I only have 5 costume changes. So all she was writing was her costume changes. She was not really writing her notes on her character. But I would do that. I would constantly say, you're glamorous, but in the last film you did this. Let's do something else in this movie. You know, kind of create a look for you. So that's, I think, what I introduced, and that's how Rangila happened.
And after that, you know, round around the same time, DDLJ too. If you can have those slides and just have a look at, you know, Kajol and how you styled Shah Rukh. Can you talk about that?
Well, again, it was Aditya Chopra. He had the entire script ready. Now I was working with directors who were young, who wanted to change the way films were. They all had their scripts ready. They all had narrations. They all wanted to do different things. They wanted the clothes to be glamorous, but yet a bit real. And like I said, it's all like-minded people coming together in the year about 94, 95. And we all got along because we loved films. For me, it was all about costumes and clothes, but also the love for films.
Right. Do we have those slides? Do we have DDLJ? Yes. These ones, you know, these also became very, very iconic. You remember the styling them? Because it's a drastic shift from Rangila, where you do all the sexy stuff. This is more conservative, hip for that time.
Well, I think that for any look, actor, song, performance to become iconic, it's very important for the film to be iconic. It's very important for the film to run. And I think all these films, whether it was Raja Hindustani with Karishma, Dilwale with Kajol, Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, or Dil To Pagal Hai.
This is Karishma.
This is Karishma and Raja Hindustani. So the first thing I did was changed her hair. Because if you remember pre this film, she had a lot of curly hair. And I thought her blue eyes would look cold on screen. So we added the brown lens. And then the director was very keen that she has a very 60s influence. And since I would watch a lot of 70s cinema, I was also very influenced by those colors and the pastel colors and the pretty colors. And that's how it all happened.
The next one. This is Madhuri from, I think, Dil To Pagal Hai.
Well, Yash Chopra was an iconic director. I loved working with him. I loved his films. This was after Chandni and after Lamhe. He always liked clothes that didn't fit the heroine. They would look real and natural. No embroidery. We would have hours of fittings and shades after shades. He loved chiffon. That was the phase. Switzerland was the phase where, you know. Another thing that I came into that phase where films from Ooty and Hyderabad were shifting to Switzerland. So every song was in Switzerland. So the heroine was in chiffon saris and the hero was in mufflers and scarves and everything. So the weather was never in question, but we would all be in Switzerland. So, and I started this whole thing of styling. So it became really important for me to be on the sets. So here, from not having traveled much in my life, I was on a flight to Switzerland every week. Like I'm here in Stanin, you know, everywhere. And then it moved out from Switzerland to London and to New York. And for me, it was so important that a character who lives in New York or lives in London can't shop their clothes in Bombay. So the clothes have to be from there. And in those days, the assistants were not allowed to just take a designer was a big deal. So here I was shopping, alterations, tacking things. The hairdressers would be helping me. It was crazy. And it was 20 hours of work.
So you're like one-man show.
But
on
that
location.
Time it was so exciting that I'm actually 1 week in Switzerland, next week in London, third, you know, like for somebody who had not traveled. And here I'm shopping at Fifth Avenue for films. And so it was a phase that was so exciting for everybody.
What a life. Next one. Preeti. Preeti actually told me that she missed most of her, you know, functions in her family because she was in Switzerland or in London, because all of you guys were shooting there on location all the time. This is Kal Ho Na Ho.
You know, recently a designer told me, you've been in the best phase of Hindi films. Today, films have become so real that they're all in small towns, which are also very pretty. But where are those days of Switzerland, London, New York, Austria? You know, so that was that phase that where the hero looks at the heroine, it goes into another shade, and the girl's in a chiffon sari in the Alps. So those were the fun days.
So working with, just before going on to the next one, working with Urmila to Kajol to Madhuri and Karishma and Preeti. I mean, you have a huge responsibility because, you know, once they've got their big break or the big film with Yash Chopra, then a lot depends on the designer also how to present them. So what did you do differently with all of these women?
So I actually, that's my nature. And I think that came in, that really helped me. Is that I actually concentrated on the job. I never really got into conversations and carrying tales or talking about anything else. So here I'm with Ravina and I'm finishing my conversation with her. And now there's a whole calamity where Karishma's clothes are concerned. For example, I would finish that entire conversation with full concentration, come out of the house and get into that entire solving that problem. That's also my nature. Like if I'm speaking to you here, I'm 100% with you. I finish this and I go on to my next thing that I have to do in the day. I think that really helped me.
Would they get hyper sometimes about their looks?
They would get hyper, but they knew that I was in control. And they had that confidence. They still do that Manish will do it. Even if it means working 24 hours, you know? So, and I mean, there would be alterations at 10 o'clock in the night and the shoot is 7 o'clock in the morning, you've got to do what you've got to do. So you've got to make the tailors. I've opened stores at 12 o'clock in the night, the lining guys, woken them up and said, listen, I need the lining. The tailor is waiting. It's 1 o'clock in the night, but this outfit has to go on set at 7. Kabhi 7 se 9 ho jata tha. But you've got to do what you've got to do.
Honestly, you have to give me an honest answer. Which was...
You don't think I was honest?
No. Now, about this question. Which actress would just, you know, lose it most of the times? Like, who would just panic about her look or who was not in control?
I mean, girls panic about their looks. They panic about clothes. Men panic. Everybody panics, right? So once you were backstage and we were all trying Priyanka's outfit and it just tore.
Priyanka.
And at that time, they called her on stage and she panicked. She was like, I was like, 2 minutes, let's just concentrate on this. My seamster, who's very fast, was there. I said, Priyanka, 2 minutes, just hang on. Let's think and we will do it. And we tacked it and chose on time. So I think sometimes you just need to be calm. So I wouldn't, even if I was hyper in my mind, I would never show hyperness otherwise. So, for example, we were shooting in Scotland and Karan said, Rani's Mangalsutra. So I said, Mangalsutra? He said, yeah, Mangalsutra. I told you to get a Mangalsutra for Rani. This is that she's like imagining she's married to Shah Rukh. This is kuch kuch hota hai. So I said, yeah, Mangalsutra. I'm getting it. Now I start walking and thinking, where is this Mangalsutra going to come in Scotland? And I see Rani's mother walking. Who's wearing a Mangalsutra? So now I tell her, I said, can you just give me this Mangalsutra? It's for your daughter. Now that Mangalsutra was in gold with a coral bead, and she was wearing a coral sari. I take it to Karan and say, I matched it so well. I'd made this Mangalsutra. And he was like, oh my God, it's lovely. And the shot happened. And in the night at dinner when we were all having, I told them what had actually happened. So sometimes when somebody else is hyper, I think you just need to be calm and say, okay, let me think. And some of our solutions do come in.
And how competitive are they? You know, because they might come and say, Manish, look, you did this with her and you have to do something better with me.
So I think that happens everywhere. A bride comes and tells you that, listen, my friend wore it, so I want something like that, but I don't want the same outfit. So I think it's just all of us.
No, but has there been any instance that there was pressure on you or somebody was like, really?
Oh, there have been. Of course, there have been. 28 years, there must have been more than 28 years.
No, but we want to share some stories today. So some stories, you want some insight.
In the sense that, like, there have been some actors who said, oh, but I did this look, and now you're doing this look with her, but... I guess when things are in fashion, there's an overlap. Everybody wants to try it. Everybody wants to do it. But it's okay.
Okay, next one. We got the next slide. We were Preeti.
If you're saying that someone shouted at me or beat me up or threw a dress on me, that's never happened.
Okay. Alia. So we come from the 90s now to this generation. You're talking about 2018. How was this project with Alia and, you know, all these young kids?
Well, I felt really nice. It was 6 years ago to do such a young film. And I'm actually one costume designer who did Jurba 1 and Jurba 2. Yeah. And I'm doing Student of the Year 1 and Student of the Year 2. Or worked with Sri Devi and worked with Janvi, or is working with Janvi. Or have had the privilege of seeing so many actresses, Rani, Preeti, Kareena, Alia, Janvi, all their first shot, the first time they ever faced the camera. So it's that long journey that I've seen. It feels great to be working with younger and younger. Today I'm working with Ananya or Tara, who are doing Student of the Year too, who are really young girls.
I really want to ask you, you know, going back to the, if we can have the Urmila Matondkar slide from the 1995 and then this Alia Bhatt bikini, you know, how has that changed? You know, because because for a viewer, now we don't see those patterns anymore. You know, we don't see that styling anymore. If you can just cue the Urmila clip once again. How do you go from that to now? How do these trends change? Because who picks them? Who decides? You know, this was the classic, okay, this is the black swimsuit, but going on.
And then the gold swimsuit with Priyanka Chopra wore as well.
In Dostana.
So here is the thing. It's not about fashion as much as about films have changed. So films have today become a lot more real. It's about reality. It's how people dress in real, they're dressing in films. Today, the actress doesn't wake up with her eyeliner. You know, she just wakes up naturally. how you would see. So if you see, the fun probably of costuming a film is not there, but so the costuming is a lot more real. Fantasy in films today is only in period films. The fantasy that we saw with the straight hair or the chiffon pallus flying to perfection is not there anymore. And I think the whole transition started with Jab We Met, which Kareena's look, where the T-shirt with salwar, that mix of Indo-Western, wearing a kurta with sneakers, or wearing it with jeans, the kurti meets a denim jacket. That whole phase which has started from that, actually today is the way everybody dresses.
So this is what you're talking about. The next slide on Urmila, not this one. On Urmila. Yeah, the
she
next.
Your favorite actress?
No. I'm just comparing. I forgot. The slide, quickly. So when she's on the bike, and that sort of, you know, there's a floral sort of pattern, and now Alia is like very basic. That's what you're saying, you know, that was, yeah. So this is more of a fantasy sort of thing that you did. This is too much happening, no, at that time?
Well, actually, if you're going to see outfit-wise, it's a very simple dress. But the whole idea of that song, and suddenly, you know, Urmila's running on a red, in the red dress, in on the where the backdrop is all stones, and Jackie Shroff is chasing her. Those looks and that, all of that, or the teacher at Sushmita Sen in Mehuna with chiffon saris flying, to all that, that has changed. Today, all this is not shown. Today's songs have become real. And she's yet wearing a dress, she's yet dancing, but the way it's shot has changed. So here, when she's even wearing something so simple, it's just a cotton peplum dress, but the way it was shot to her expressions, to her hair, to her running, was a little more poetic, dramatic, all of that. But today, it's shot more real.
Right, that's why I go to Alia, and that is the contemporary style, I think, now. So, but another criticism now is that everybody's looking the same. All of these girls, all of these guys are looking the same, you know, from everybody from, let's say, Suraj Pancholi to Tiger Shroff to Akshay Kumar to Shah Rukh Khan to Salman Khan. Everybody has to have a six-pack. If they don't have a six-pack, they'll get a photoshopped six-pack. It's the similar look for the girls as well. You know, this very lean, sort of fit, athletic figure. What do you have to say about this? That everyone's looking the same.
Well, I think that's always been there. If you see all the 60s films, when all those beautiful actors did those hairdos, which were so tedious, flowers, chiffon saris, pastel color chiffon saris with slight embroidery, that was the look. All the heroes wore the mufflers and all of that. Coming to the 70s, which was all flower power, big collars, and things like that. But today, I think you're seeing the actors a lot more than you saw them before. Earlier, you saw them in films. Today, you're seeing them, in fact, in the last 1 year, there are airport looks, there are salon looks, where they're coming out of salon, then they attended a party, that's there. You know, then there are events, then there are movies. In fact, I feel the movies have become less. You're looking at their looks, what she wore for Diwali, what she wore for Navratri, what she wore for a wedding. So it's all of that. You're seeing too much. And because you're seeing too much, you're thinking that everybody is looking the same. Because they're all following this A group of stylists, A group of designers. And the actors are also like, they have so much to do every day, that they are just going by the looks that are presently happening. That's what's happening.
You're essentially saying business is great.
No, I'm not saying business is great, because it's a lot of styling, but I'm just saying that there's too much today. And that's the new social media, and that's the world we live in today.
Okay, Manish, all these years, you know, your favorite five styling jobs that you did, or costumes that you did, five iconic looks.
Well, I would think movie-wise, it would be Rangila for sure. It would be Dil To Pagal Hai, Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. Kabhi Alvida Na Kehna is a film that I really think I did a lot of work, dressing Mr. Bachchan, Abhishek as well, Shah Rukh, Rani, Preeti, days in New York. So it's a film that I feel a lot was done. And I would say Jab We Met, because I think that look completely set a different method of dressing in India.
And I remember, you know, you were known as the filmy designer, you know, when it started off. So from both perspectives, from the film industry, you were their guy, you know, you were like okay, there's this big designer who's helping us. But in the fashion industry, how did they look at you? You know, did they look down upon you? Ke, hey, ye film mein kaam karta
hai? I think they still do that. But I think that it was the first time that somebody from costumes was coming into mainstream. For a couple of years, it was a bit shaky for me as well, because I was so busy with movies. But I think with years and a lot of work and extra hours, I kind of changed the product, changed the look. Till day, I stress on what's the next step. We launched big stores. And today, we are in a very important part of mainstream, whether it's been fashion weeks, whether it's been a lot of clients, whether it's been weddings. So it's a very different journey. All I can say is that I'm the only designer who has that strange journey from modeling to costumes, costumes to mainstream, to doing movies, to weddings, to fashion weeks. It's a journey, and it's I think now is that crucial time. Where do I take my brand from here? I reduce my films and do a lot more with mainstream. So it's unique.
I remember a lot of designers were against this concept of showstoppers from the film industry, and you had them. And now everyone wants a showstopper.
There are a couple of things that I started. One was shimmer and sparkle and sequence, which is big even internationally today. Not that I influence them. I'm just saying that that's their trick, glamour. Secondly is the showstopper. Today it's a profession. Actors get paid to be a showstopper. And I had Urmila as a showstopper because of emotion. That is my first fashion show. We did Rangila together, So You Should Walk. And the front row, the whole thing of actors being in the front row who kind of wear your clothes and like your work. Today's become a norm. So these are the three things that I started.
Okay, your favorite designer, who's your favorite designer, and your favorite stars to style, male and female.
My favorite stars?
Who you like to style, or who you've styled. You have to give us specific.
So I like all designers because I think individually, each one has something to say. They have their narratives and their storytelling. And where actors are concerned, I think that it's a phase, you know. You work so much with them that times are irritated. What is she saying? Why does she want this change? And when it all works around, you're happy. But you're irritated with your mother sometimes, your friend, your spouse, your people you work with. So it's just a part of that journey. What I have really, really to thank the film industry, that I think whatever has happened in my life and all that I've seen or know, and it's all thanks to films.
But you're not giving me names.
No.
Two favorites, no? All time?
Well, I loved working with Sridevi.
Okay.
Because she was somebody who I really looked up to. And I started working with her at a very early stage of my career. And I think I learned a lot from her. She had a lot of knowledge about costumes. For example, little things like no lining in the sleeves, you know, the way you stitch the skirts, how do they look more slimmer at a shooting on a film set. I learned so much from her. And of course, Rekha, for being, I've been recently doing a lot of work with her, and she's somebody I really admire.
Right.
I just love the madness that she comes with. She's truly iconic.
Right, final question to you now, Manish. And since I am a news person, the Me Too campaign right now, you know, it's really picked up steam. I'm getting one update per minute. You know, it's horrible, disturbing, disgusting stories that are coming out. We've had almost like 20 names in the last 3 days.
That's right.
Big names.
Yes.
In the fashion industry too. You know, I'm sure these stories exist. And in the fashion industry, both men and women are preyed on.
Yes.
Can you talk about that?
Well, I think that it's a movement which is very delayed, late. It should have been started long before. And I think that, like it says, that everybody has a right to speak up and accept what they want to go with and say no to what they don't want to. And any kind of force is not good or correct. And look, we are right now just seeing the film industry or looking at the fashion industry, but I'm sure it's happening all over in a lot of other industries and offices, you know? And I think that women speaking and objecting and putting a no, I think should have happened long back. And I'm really glad that this is happening.
Right. Manish Malhotra, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.